Hey, what's up, rock stars? It's Rox, and I am coming to you today, sadly so, you guys, for the review of Power Season 6, Episode 4 or 5. Is this 5? I think it's Episode 5, you guys. I'm distracted because there's a wrecker right in front of me, and it's towing one of the employees. They're towing his car. So it's people pushing the car. It's a whole bunch of shit activity going on right in front of my car, you guys. But we gonna go on because the job must get done, okay? And we got a lot to talk about with Power, you guys. Okay. I'll do it in order, okay? All things decent and in order. So let's get to it, shall we? All right, you guys, so the show starts with Tariq playing chess with his girl, okay? It's not officially his girl yet, but obviously they are getting close, all right? But you know what? He can't talk to her long because Vincent sends him a text. It was just like, pay up, motherfucker, okay? Twice the shipment. He wants it today, okay? And immediately, Tariq is stressed. You know, old girl, she does, you know, notice that he seems to be stressed, but we still don't quite know what's up with her. We've come to the conclusion that she's either related to Ray Ray, who was killed by Tariq, might be working with the feds, maybe related to old boy that Ghost killed at the beginning of the season. So it could be a number of people who she is, but she's shady, whatever it is. We got our good eye on her. Now we see James, he's in the capacity of James right now. He's telling Tate, Councilman Tate and Ramona that he can't do this anymore. You know, he's just got too much shit going on. Maybe he's not the man for the job. You know, he needs to step back from Tate's campaign. You know, Tate is all for it. Oh yes, you know, well, we do appreciate you and Ramona, you know, cause the bitch is salivating at the fact that she, you know, just had him right in her grip. Like they hung a raw piece of steak in front of a fucking pit bull. She's just like, no, you can't do that. And he was just like, yeah, I gotta go, you know, and it's Tate's call anyway. She says, nope, we can't do that. You know, the people, the big people in the DNC, they want him to come and represent, you know, so he can pump this whole thing up at some next event that they have. And again, James was like, nope, it's on Tate. And Tate was like, well, we thank you for your service, because, you know, Tate is trying to separate himself from James St. Patrick the best way that he can. But when Tate walks away, you know, she goes on and tries to give him the same bullshit that she gave Tasha. Bitch, go on some fucking way with your old hot and ass. We see extremely annoying, and she's talking to Overly Dedicated, and she's saying that James couldn't not have killed Angela because he was too close, okay? Her wound was right here. Her blood splatter was also, you know, right up in the here area. So, I mean, unless he's shooting a bitch like this, you know, no, that's not what happened. Somebody shot him from over his head. He didn't probably even see the person. So now maybe we should be thinking about, if we're trying to catch who killed Angela, we should be thinking about who James St. Patrick might be getting revenge on. But you know, Overly Dedicated don't give a fuck about that person. He wants James St. Patrick. So he meets Andre out in the middle of, you know, the streets in New York. And this motherfucker got Andre's little girl in the car. She sees her daddy. She's crying. And, you know, Overly Dedicated was just like, you're not going to get your girl back. Look at over there, just a crying, just a sad. She want her dad. But you ain't going to see her again unless you give me some shit on St. Patrick. Andre was like, you doing some fucking slave shit right now. Like, give me my daughter. Overly Dedicated was like, I'm not a slave master. I said, this was the moment right then where I said, Overly Dedicated has definitely turned the corner. Okay. He has officially become not just as bad, but he has definitely become a bad rogue detective in this whole thing. And that was when I decided right then that Overly Dedicated is definitely slated to die before this season is over. It's gonna happen, you guys. Anyway, get me some shit on St. Patrick, okay? But Overly Dedicated can't talk because he gets a text message from, you know, Big Boss Golden Black. Okay, get your ass down here. Well, Golden Blatt is mad because what is this I see about all these FBI agents having to get paid overtime because you had them go rush over to Maria Suarez's house. I mean, her apartment. Then they don't need her or something like, what the fuck is this? Okay, did you know anything about this? Extremely annoying. Oh, extremely annoying. She didn't know. Okay, but now she looking at Overly Dedicated side eye too. Like, what the hell is going on here? Now Overly Dedicated has to come clean and say, Yeah, he did have it set up for them to come over there and get James, but he didn't kill the girl, but he did give her some money. Well, how is it that James St. Patrick even knew where the girl was? Isn't that your witness? Oh, he lets out that he'd been talking to Andre and all this. They were like, you have fucked this up. And he was like, no, I haven't, because, you know, he still got Proctor's ex-wife. And they were like, yeah, well, you would if she wasn't dead. She overdosed yesterday, so we cannot use her. And like I said, you have fucked this up, okay? Oh, and how did we know that she overdosed? Well, Proctor called in, made the call, and he was just like, they were like, well, why was Proctor over there? You know, I mean, that's easily explainable, but now overly dedicated has to, now he's got to do some research on his own. He doesn't let up on that unicorn, but we know that unicorn is still out there. Now we jump over to Andre. Now he's talking to Ghost. They at the club, and he's telling him, you know, let me in on whatever you got with going on with Jason. And Ghost is like, there's nothing going on with Jason. I told him I'm not gonna be his distributor. I'm out of the game, okay? And Andre was like, oh, and he was okay with that? Okay, well then fine, let me step in, let me be the distributor. And he was just like, man, please, first of all, if you become a distributor and you working with the feds, okay, they gonna find out about that, and you gonna be in trouble. And then if Jason finds out that you working with the fucking feds, then we both gonna be in trouble. So what sense does that make? You know, Andre, yeah, you right. Andre don't know what the fuck to do. Po-thing just trying to get his damn daughter back. Now we see overly dedicated. Him and Big Boss Golden Black go over to Proctor's house. You know, Proctor was at the house talking to his cousin. And then when he sees that it's the feds, you know, he tells his cousin, you know, make sure, you know, his daughter is gone and go in the other room. And so he opens the door and he was just like, listen, I'm on bereavement. And, you know, they want to know why he was there. He was like, my daughter called me and told me, you know, what happened. Overly dedicated, now all of a sudden he's got a full bladder, he's got to use the bathroom, you know. And Proctor knows that it's bullshit, but whatever, you know, go on back there, use the bathroom, bring your ass back up here. And it's quite convenient, but you know what, listen, we, like somebody told me in my comments last week, we gonna have to suspend, you know, all belief just so that we can you know, regular common sense thinking, just so we can get through this season. Overly dedicated is actually able to go walk back in the back room and see the backpack with the unicorn on it, and get the unicorn off of the girl's backpack. Fine. So when they leave, Proctor goes to James, and he was like, what the fuck? I thought you was gonna go and kill old girl. Ghost was like, I'm not gonna kill her because she was innocent back then and she's innocent now, okay? Again, Ghost just been trying to preach this whole I'm good, I'm out the game, I'm trying to do better thing the whole time that he's been on the show. He keeps on getting pulled back in. He was like, I'm not killing her, she's innocent. Proctor was like, well, she not innocent because she knows everything, and if she goes and tells everything, then you know what, you going down, Tommy going down, I'm going down, everything is going down. If that girl talks, she needs to die. Ghost tells him, you know what, go on and excuse yourself, because Ghost has already made a decision. He's not doing that, even though Proctor tried to tell him that she is still going to testify against him, even though he gave her that money, okay? So, well, I guess, you know, Ghost is just trying to come to terms with himself and the shit that he's done in the past. After Proctor leaves, then here we go, that whole Ramona comes send him a text like, okay, that event I was telling you about Tate bombed, okay? We really, really need you. I said, I bet you do, yo, loose pussy ass. So Proctor, now that it didn't work with Ghost, he meets with Tommy in the park. And, you know, Tommy is more of a loose cannon. So even though, you know, Proctor knows a fool is crazy, he tell him also the same thing that he tells Ghost. Basically, she needs to die. Tommy was like, oh, when did you switch over to the dark side? When he started fucking around with you guys, that's when. Okay, well, where does she live? Okay, and then when Proctor leaves there, he goes over to Overly Dedicated. And I was like, damn, Proctor. I hated to see him do it, but I see why he had to. He still wasn't turning on Ghost, okay? But he did tell Overly Dedicated that Ghost was not the one who killed Angela, that it was actually Tommy, okay? He worked out this deal with him, like, you know, he's gonna be immune, you know, this ain't no paperwork and none of that shit. It's just, he gonna show up at the court case, he gonna testify, and then him and his daughter are out. But Overly Dedicated don't want to hear Tommy. No, this is a plot to get James St. Patrick. So all the rest of the shit you talking is just that shit. Proctor's like, I done did my part, Okay, so I don't know what else to tell you. And Proctor does all of this because Overly Dedicated knew about the unicorn and the fact that he had let the wife die, even though somebody in my comments mentioned that none of that would have been admissible. And even Proctor said that he would sue him if he did, but then Overly Dedicated was just like, I'm still gonna let your daughter hear, you know, that you let her mother die. You know, you don't want that. So that's how he kind of wrangled Proctor into that corner. So Proctor goes home, he's all stressed out with the cousin, like, I fucked up, you know, I did this, I let, you know, I set the ex-wife up and said all this shit I knew she was going to use. And now Overly Dedicated is all over him telling him he got a turn. Well, his cousin was just like, you know, we don't do rats around here, all right? It push come to shove, and the feds is all trying to get James and Tommy, then seems to me your problems would be taken care of if you kill them motherfuckers, okay? And that'll get everybody off your back, and then you can move forward with your life. Now, I'm gonna help you out. Let me give you this gun. You keep this with you. Keep yourself safe. And at the moment, I'm thinking that's the only protection he had, because he told his cousin that he had gotten rid of the laptop, you know, because that was the only thing that tied him to that Markham boy. So he don't have that anymore. But I was like, you gotta be smarter than that, Proctor, as the lawyer that you are, with your life on the line and you're in the hands of James and Tommy. So I still wasn't real, I didn't believe him, but then I was just like, well, maybe. But I was like, Now let's jump over to Tasha. Tasha is talking to Tommy and she's telling him how she needs money because it's just all this overhead and she barely got any money, you know, even with this daycare. And he was just like, well, I'll talk to Keisha and see if I can get some money from you, for you, from you, for you. She thought that that meant that she gonna be washing money through her daycare. And he was like, no, that's not what I'm saying. You know, Keisha's doing that in the in her own business. Okay, remember, you the one that taught her the ropes. And Tasha was just like, well, she better not fuck it up, because she got all of it, you know, we all riding on that one. Tommy also got one for Tasha. He wants to know how he can get into that penthouse. And she was just like, what, why? So you can get the ghost? Like, ghost is not, you don't need to kill him right now, okay? That's the least of the problems. It's not a good time. Everything that's going on, you don't need to do that. So no. Tasha goes back into her her place of business, and it's the end of the evening, and she didn't wait an hour for one of her more ratchet, you know, customers to come pick up their child. Now, time, you supposed to be here by 6, bitch. It's 7 something. And you know, girl, like I said, she ratchet. Oh, girl, you know, she the single mama. She give you that whole spiel, you know, but also, you know, she about to go party and she gonna do this, and you know, she gonna promise Tasha she'll pay her twice the money, you know, the next day if she don't have to pay this $100 late fee for showing up. Tasha says fine. When she leaves there, she meets another shady character. First, he's look like he threatening he gonna do something, but you know, Tasha, she didn't been around the corner, she didn't been around the block a few times, you know, so she ain't really necessarily scared. Plus, she got cameras and everything. And he basically is shaking her down, saying that if she wants to be protected on the streets better than them damn cameras, then you gonna have to pay him weekly. If you don't, it will be a shame if, you know, he got to put this place to fire. So he give Tasha something to think about. A few days later, Tasha's at the store, and she's having some money issues. The lady was like, the ATM right out there, bitch. If it ain't no money here, it ain't none in the ATM either. While she's there, here go Keisha, all high and mighty, sediddy, okay, uppity. You know, she's switched places. She's got her Chanel bag, and she's shopping and all of this. And, you know, hey, Tasha. But she can't keep it going because she still needs Tasha. She need to find out what happened to Holly. Okay, the mama was in town and kind of put it in her thoughts about Holly. And you know, Keisha was just like, Tasha was like, oh, you know, you don't need to worry about it. Basically, Holly got in too deep, and you just need to be careful, you know, because Tommy ain't one to play with. And you know, oh, Keisha was just like, you ain't got to worry about that. I got Tommy on lock, honey. Nobody has Tommy on lock. Tommy don't even have Tommy on lock. Okay, so I was just like, girl, you, okay, she believes that. All right, so she just, whatever. Oh, that Keisha. I would like to see Keisha go on and kick the bucket. Well, I shouldn't say that, but something tells me that Keisha's not gonna die. She don't feel like she's on the target list to die. She gonna come close, but I Well, we'll see. But what do you guys think? I don't know. I'm just not feeling. I'm not getting the feeling that Keisha gonna die. Now, back to Tariq. So, you know, he got to do what he got to do. He got these drugs, but he don't have enough. You know, Vincent said double the amount, right? And he didn't steal enough, double the amount. I mean, you was in that fucking warehouse. You needed to get as much as you can, boy, your dumb self. So now he got to do what he got to do. He going to cut these drugs, you know, put some baby aspirin in with the other drugs and put them, compare them together. And, oh, they look like that might be the same thing. So stupid. Like, don't everybody know that you can't do this kind of shit, especially with these cutthroats like this? Like, that boy don't have no good sense. So he mixes it up, and then he goes on over to Vincent's, and Vincent was like, listen, I've taken a big chance on you, so you better not fuck me. And Tariq says, you know, he's trustworthy, you can trust him, don't worry about it. So, you know, Vincent doesn't take the time. I guess it's sort of insulting to check shit right then, okay, trying to give him the benefit of the doubt. See, that benefit of the doubt gonna get your ass killed, Tariq. So he just shakes it, sees that it's full, feels right, the bag feel like it got the right amount of pills or whatever, fine, okay. Vincent seems to be happy for now. But when Tariq take it on back to school, Tasha then got called down there by the dean. Yeah, they gonna expel Tariq for selling drugs. Well, Tariq says, well, it's just baby aspirin. Okay, but the dean says, but do the students know that it's baby aspirin? Nope, they don't know that. Okay, so your ass is expelled. Get the stepping. So, you know, Tasha mad. Like, you know, where did you get these drugs from and all of this? And she, come on, get your shit and you need to go. So back at Ghost Penthouse, Proctor shows up there. And I guess Proctor thought it was a good idea to hide out at Ghost House, considering he knows that Ghost and Tommy are at odds. That he knows that Tommy is not going to be over at Ghost House. There's really like no way for Tommy to get up in there. And maybe this was the safest place for him and his daughter. This is what I'm thinking Proctor was thinking in his mind. Ghost doesn't know about all of this other shit going on. So, you know, Ghost, even though he's like, this ain't really a safe house, you know, but Proctor was like, please, I don't know where to go. You know, Proctor tells him that he's got to testify against a witness, you know, another case, but you know, he just needs to hide out here instead of staying at his apartment because the other witness knows where he lives. So Ghost says okay. When Proctor and his daughter go back in the room, here come Tasha and Tariq. She was just like, tell your daddy why you was expelled. What did you do? All the motherfuckers selling drugs at the school. Tasha, did you know this? Nigga, do you think that Tasha knew that? Why the fuck do you think Tasha would be okay with her son selling drugs? No, she did not know that. Well, where did you get these drugs from? He not gonna say Tommy. He says Kanan. Oh, Kanan, huh? You know, Ghost was like, oh, so you wanna be just like him? And Tariq laughs at him like, I'm just like you, okay? What else did you expect me to be? And Ghost was like, listen, nigga, this is different, okay? I had to do what I had to do to get out of that life that I lived. You know, it was on the streets. It was cutthroat. It was bad. You didn't have no money, okay? You don't have to do this. This is going to ruin your life. You know, Tariq is so flippant and everything that Ghost want to whoop his ass, you know, and Tasha stop him. Wait a minute. I said, no, see, that's the problem. Somebody need to whoop Tariq's ass one good time, just, you know, just pam pam right here in the chest. So she lets Tariq go, and you know, he said it's your fault because you the one that, you know, drew Kanan out by using him. And you know, so that's what James does best. He always tries to blame anybody else except for himself, okay? When you ultimately are you're the big picture, the big piece, and everybody else is around you. Tasha and Ghost are arguing back and forth, and then, you know, here come Proctor with the the damn church finger. Excuse me. Okay, can I get my shit over there? Tasha was like, get all you want, because Tasha's out of here. So after he goes back into the room, you know, his daughter is asking, why are we staying here with you? Oh, I forgot to tell you guys an important part. When Proctor was talking to his cousin, the little girl was supposedly asleep in the other room, but she overheard everything that they were saying. Okay, so keep that part in mind. But anyway, while she is asking her father, why are we here? You know, why we can't stay with the cousin? And, you know, Proctor says, oh, this is a better place for us. And, you know, but I know it's been hard for you, so I got a present for you. So he gives her a locket and he says, see, and inside here, you know, that's, you know, our little secret. You know, if something happens to daddy, you know, that's what you have right there. And she's like, can I see it now? And he says, no, you just keep it right here, you know, close to your heart. Okay. But you have that. Okay. So she doesn't really understand the, you know, the full weight of what she has around her neck. She just knows that she has this necklace around her, you know, this necklace that her daddy gave her. And then when Tasha left there, she goes back and she's talking to Tommy in the car again. Listen, Keisha asking about Holly, okay? And he's like, thanks to my mom, you know, she done said some shit. Enough about my mama though, how's Tariq? And she says, oh, Tariq, you know, he over at the school getting expelled for selling drugs. You know, supposedly Kanan gave it to him. When she took him over to James' house, you know, then Proctor is over there. You know, he's staying there for whatever reason. And I was just like, child, you done told Tommy an earful now. She don't even know it, though. Because she wistful about her old life and, you know, her penthouse. And she just can't believe all this shit is going on there now. And that she living in some little hole in the wall, you know, when you compare it to the penthouse. But you gonna give me that money, right? No, can't give you the money because he told Keisha about it. And she was pissed off. And she was just like, oh, and I mean, you ain't giving me no money because she pissed off. Is the pussy that good? He said he not gonna lie to Keisha. And she was just like, that's fine, okay? But you felt the same way about Holly when I tried to tell you about her too. He was just like, you know what, Tasha? I got somewhere to be, so get the fuck out of my car. So Tasha leaves from there, okay? And she frustrated with him. She slammed the door, walking back up to her place, and there go old boy, the one that said he was gonna burn it down. But like I said, Tasha been around the block, so she walk up to him, you know, real confident, like, you obviously don't know who I am. But baby, I got a business proposition for you. Okay, you talking about this little bit of wheat that you want for me for protection, but honey, we could make a whole bunch more together. And he was just like, oh, really? Word? Okay, I guess he gonna have to go do his research, like you guys like to tell me all the time. Do your research. Anyway, he gonna go do his research, and yeah, we gonna talk later. I said, oh yeah, you definitely gonna talk. Wouldn't it be something if Tasha ends up being on top of this whole game, that Courtney let her be the loser all these five seasons just to finally end on top? Because Tasha has lost more consistently than anybody. Now, Tommy got to take care of Miss Maria Suarez. You know, I'm assuming Proctor told him where she lives. Okay, so he breaks into the place, but he got to hide in the closet because she actually gets home and she's with Overly Dedicated. So it looks like she's talking to Overly Dedicated. She done changed up her story. You know, she trying to do all of this implicating and who did this. You know, she said she saw something she forgot about and all of that. Okay, Overly Dedicated is his concern, and he kind of trying to get her to confess that she took this money, but she don't say that. So, of course, when Overly Dedicated come out, leave on out, Tommy come on out the closet and he, you know, shoot the bitch right up in here area. She dead. Okay, so we done took her out. At the same time, we see Ghost having dinner. Well, he's in the capacity of James St. Patrick having dinner with Ramona. And again, she's doing all this, you know, come on back, this is a second chance and all that, and it's not going to define her. And you know, Ghost was just like, I'm gonna have to think about it, you know, but can we do this again, you know, dinner? And she, oh yes, of course we can. Bitch, that's all you wanted. Why don't you just go on and say that? You don't even know that, you know, you ain't got to go through all of this with Ghost, okay? He'll go on and fuck you. Remember what we had with Garcelle Beauvais? Shit. Now, let's jump over to Markham. We ain't seen him in a long time, you guys. And turns out he calls Proctor, trying to find out where Proctor is. Proctor says, okay, I'm not at the house. You know, I'm in Tribeca somewhere. But, you know, Markham wants to meet with him. Proctor says he can't do that right now, you know, maybe later. But when he gets off the phone, we see that Markham is in the trunk. Okay, and he's talking to one of, you know, I can't even remember one of Tommy's goons, the stupid one of them. He tells him that Proctor is in Tribeca now. Can I go? I was like, do you really think you about to go? You in the trunk tied up with a man standing looking down at you, stupid? No, you cannot go unless it's to heaven or hell, which is, you know, he gets shot, he dead. And then the goon calls Tommy and says, well, Proctor is over in Tribeca, but I'm not sure where. And Tommy was like, I know where it is. So Tommy calls Tariq, and Tariq was like, oh, Uncle Tommy, I can explain, because he think he calling about selling them drugs. But he was just like, I already heard about you being expelled and selling drugs. We'll talk about that later. But listen, I'm gonna need you to leave that back door to the penthouse. I said, y'all got back doors at penthouses? I mean, I guess. So yeah, leave that back door open. You get the fuck up out of there. He was like, I thought you said you was gonna tell me if you was gonna make a move on my dad. He said, I'm not trying to make no move on your dad. Your dad is safe. He know it's going to be on Proctor. So when Tariq is leaving out, he hears Proctor's daughter in there crying. You know, she's looking at old pictures of her mom. And, you know, Tariq felt bad for her. It was just like, you know, can, how about you and I go and get us some ice cream? She don't want ice cream. Well, how about hot chocolate? And she says, okay. So she puts on her stuff to go. And Tariq feel a little bad. I was like, now you can't be cutthroat and hoard and then be sitting up here feeling bad about what's about to happen. It's, you know, charge into the game. Okay, so leave the back door open and get the fuck out. So that's what he does. He leaves the back door open and him and the girl leaves. Now, another time where we must suspend all, you know, reality, you guys. Tommy goes in there. Now, it's not unrealistic for us to assume that Tommy is going to go in there and try to kill Proctor, right? Okay, go in there with a fucking silencer. Sneak up on him and shoot him. Okay, because you in Tribeca in the penthouse. You are at a place where I'm sure the police are heavy. It's not like they in the middle of the hood somewhere where it might take them some time to get there. And he goes in there, and this motherfucker got a automatic machine gun. Okay, he not just like pow, pow. You know, he like brrr, pow, 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 brrr, brrr. Proctor's the one that's pow, pow. I was like, boy, in retrospect, your cousin didn't do you that well with this one little gun, okay? But Proctor's, you know, he's trying to defend himself. You got to give it up to him, y'all. Look at me just sweating under my arms. And Tommy is actually shocked, like, oh, this nigga got a little bit of wart in him, a little bit of wart. Proctor runs in the other room. Now, the penthouse is big, so he's running around. You know, I didn't realize it was this big, but bitch is big, obviously. He going to different rooms. He trying to find his daughter. Well, his daughter's not there. She's having a, you know, a leisurely a stroll and cup of hot chocolate with Tariq. So he calls her. Where are you? She was like, I'm here at the, you know, Starbucks, for lack of better words. I'm here getting hot chocolate with Tariq. He says, so you're not here? And she says, no. Should we head back? And he says, no, don't come back here. Okay, go to your cousin's house. You know, you're going to be safe there. And then she was just like, Daddy, am I going to see you again? I'll see you there later. And he started crying. You guys, when he did that, my heart broke. Because as much as I didn't want to say it was going to happen, I knew it was about to happen. And so did Proctor. And Proctor was just like, no, baby, you won't see me. Oh, I tell you, I was like, I was so fucking mad at Courtney. Like, really? You guys are killing Proctor, who, you know, but he's a good dude. He is not a bad guy. He did not, but you know, Tommy is the one. Oh, I was just like, whoa, this, when he did that, you guys, my stomach sunk, because I was just like, this is it for Proctor. He tried to barricade the door, but Tommy gets in there. He's got a fucking submachine gun, you know, so he gets in there, and, you know, you're going to Proctor again with the pow, pow. Tommy just sprays him, kills him. He's dead, okay? I think it was 6 bullet holes in the chest, you know, so he died like a man. He didn't try to hide it out or anything, okay? But I was so fucking sad. I was just like, Courtney, you bitch. You really not gonna let us have Proctor? Oh, anybody can get it. And that was a mistake for Tommy. This is how I see it happening, okay? Tommy gonna die. Ghost gonna go to jail, okay? But we'll talk about that towards the end. Just let me finish this up for y'all. So then we get towards the end and all the little shit starts to fall in place. We see Tasha, she talking to the ratchet baby mama, you know, customer who has her little, who's, you know, Tasha watches and tells her she got a proposition for her. So it looked like Tasha trying to set up her own little empire. That's why I was like, oh, Tasha might be the one to come out on top. We see Tariq, he takes the little girl to the cousin's house, you know, and when she runs into the cousin's arms, he knows that means her daddy is gone. And he sees Tariq standing across the street. So he kind of nods to him like, okay, thanks for that. And Tariq nods back at him. And you think that's going to be it. But then Tariq gets picked up by Vincent's boys. I said, oh, that's your ass, nigga. That's your ass. And then, of course, we see James, you know, who had been out eating with that damn Ramona while his house is getting shot up. Okay, now the police then finally all made it there. You know, I'm assuming Tommy has gotten out safe and sound. Not Proctor, though. You know, James was like, what's going on? You know, this is my house. You know, they keep on telling him he can't come in. But he was like, my son, where's my son? You know, he should have been here. And they're like, your son ain't here, Proctor dead. Why is it that everybody around you keeps getting killed? All right, maybe they after your ass. Like, what the fuck going on here? Okay, that's extremely annoying and overly dedicated. But then he gets a call from Tariq, and he was like, I gotta take this. This is my son. And so when he listens, you know, you just hear Tariq say, Dad. I said, what the fuck you done got your ass into now? See, that's why you shouldn't have gave Vincent them damn baby aspirin. Then we see Tommy getting a text message, you know, for him to meet Tariq in some place. I'm thinking that's a dark alley, but then when I finally see Tommy pulling up, it's actually like an old fairground. Then all of a sudden Ghost shows up out of the shadows like only Ghost can. You know, Tommy's like, I should have known it was a setup, and Ghost was like, I didn't set you up, you know, to come here. And then Vincent comes out and he says, yeah, I did, while we all bullshitting around here. Okay, your dumbass son then sold me some fucking baby aspirin, and because he done did that, this is what the proposition is for you. Okay, I'm gonna kill the little nigga unless you give me $2 million. Okay, and that's just what it is. The reason why I believe that Tommy is gonna die is because Tommy has done a little bit too much on the side of wrong, that his karma, I think, is gonna catch up with him. As far as Ghost, I think that Ghost is gonna go to jail behind Tariq, okay? Because we already saw next week that Ghost is gonna have to get back in the game to try to get this $2 million for, you know, Tariq's ransom. And yeah, I think that Ghost is gonna get caught. He gonna go to jail. Tommy gonna get dead. Tasha gonna be back in the game. It's still the verdict is out on what's gonna happen with Tariq, but well, we do know what's gonna happen with Tariq. He's gonna be a drug dealer. But you know, I just kind of feel like that's the direction that they swaying us in. I know that 50 Cent did say that you know, by episode 6, that everything is just gonna be so topsy-turvy that we ain't gonna know what to think. But what do you guys think is gonna happen there, you guys? It was a good episode, but I'm telling you, it sure did make me sad to see Proctor go. Proctor! I wanted Proctor to make it out, didn't y'all? All right, rock stars, that's it. Let me get on back to work. Make sure that you rate, comment, and subscribe to the channel. I'm It's Rocks. The channel's for It's Rocks. Everything else I do, be in the bottom box. All right. So I hope that you have a wonderful, wonderful rest of your day, and I plan on doing the same. Till next time, rock stars. Bye.